Navigating the Vast Seas of Jazz, the classic album The Right Touch emerges as an example of Duke Pearson's genius. But what sets this album apart in the vast ocean of jazz classics? Today, we will find out as we dive deep into this classic album. So grab you some popcorn, sit back, relax, and enjoy this video. But before you do this, please smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and ring that notification bell. Thanks. Recorded on September 13, 1967, The Right Touch captures a pivotal moment in jazz history and a standing testament to Pearson's brilliance. Recorded at the legendary Van Gelder Studio in Englewood Cliffs, New Jersey, this album encapsulates various jazz styles, with Rudy Van Gelder, the maestro behind the console, ensuring that every note was captured with precision. It was released in 1968 and was immediately recognized as a significant work in the jazz community, garnering acclaim for its innovative compositions and arrangements. From its inception to today's reissues, The Right Touch has been an example of jazz excellence, reflecting Pearson's vast talents and the proficiency of the band he collaborated with. This album found new life in the recently released Tone Poet series reissue, which was accurately mastered from the original analog tapes by Kevin Gray at his Coherent Audio Studio, and it was pressed onto 180-gram vinyl at RTI. Gray's mastering is nothing short of a revelation, bringing out the clarity, depth, and nuance of each instrument. The pressing is remarkably quiet, allowing for a pristine listening experience where Freddie Hubbard's airy trumpet and Stanley Turrentine's robust tenor shines through. Now for the music. The track Chili Peppers immediately captivates with its vibrant Latin rhythms, led by Pearson's dynamic piano melodies. Freddie Hubbard's emotive trumpet solos and James Spaulding's rich alto interludes add layers of depth and complexity to the track. Together, the band crafts a piece that's a brilliant fusion of heat, energy, and jazz artistry. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Next up, we have the track Make It Good, which stands out as a breezy swing number, exuding a relaxed yet captivating vibe. Pearson's piano work shines brilliantly, weaving complex melodies that are beautifully complemented by Turrentine's deep, soulful tenor lines. Meanwhile, Hubbard's trumpet adds flair with subtle accents, enhancing the track's overall harmony and depth. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Next, we have the track, Los Malos Hombres, a masterfully blended fiery essence of Latin beats with the sophistication of jazz, which is a testament to Pearson's innovative composition skills. Hubbard's trumpet solos punctuate the track with bursts of brilliance, adding a layer of excitement and vigor. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. We'll be right back. Now for the musicians on this classic. Duke Pearson, renowned for his exceptional skills as a jazz pianist and composer, played a pivotal role in defining the iconic sound of Blue Note records during its golden era in the 1960s. On the right touch, Pearson's multifaceted talents shine through, from his intricate piano melodies to his innovative compositions and arrangements. This album, with its unique blend of tracks and collaborations, remains one of the crowning jewels in Pearson's illustrious musical legacy. Freddie Hubbard, renowned for his collaborations with jazz icons like John Coltrane, brought a unique resonance to the right touch with his airy trumpet tones. His mastery added depth and emotion, making his contributions pivotal to the album's tone. Garnett Brown's expertise as a trombonist has led him to collaborate with jazz luminaries. On the right touch, his distinctive trombone lines enrich the album, adding strength and a unique sonic layer to the band. James Spaulding, renowned for his resounding alto tones, has a legacy of collaborations with jazz legends. His soulful saxophone contributions in the right touch infuse the album with warmth and elevate its musical depth. Stanley Turrentine's soulful tenor sax had cemented his reputation in the jazz realm even before joining the band for the right touch. In the album, he seamlessly blends soulful undertones with melodic brilliance, enhancing the overall musical narrative. Gene Taylor's expertise on the bass is characterized by a unique blend of rhythm and melody, making him a standout in the jazz community. On the right touch, Taylor's pronounced and punchy bass lines anchor the compositions, offering a robust backbone that complements the album's intricate melodies. Grady Tate's prowess on the drum strikes a balance between finesse and powerful energy, showcasing his versatility as a percussionist. On the right touch, Tate's masterful use of cymbals and snares infuses the compositions with a lively rhythm, propelling each track with energy and momentum. Today, decades after its release, the right touch continues to shine, capturing the hearts of both seasoned jazz aficionados and newer fans discovering its magic. The album's enduring appeal and unmatched artistry ensure that its place in jazz history remains prominent and celebrated. I want to thank you for journeying with us through the rich history of this iconic album, The Right Touch. Stay tuned for more insights and deep dives into the jazz vinyl world. But before you go, please smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and ring that notification bell. And until next time, keep the jazz alive and the vinyl spinning. Bye for now. If you are interested in more deep dives into the world of jazz vinyl, then click on this video right here, where we take you on a journey into John Coltrane's classic album Soul Train.